Hello, Ace. This is RetroTK2 and welcome to this Windows tutorial. Today we're adding custom icons to the system tray, aka the notification area. So let's get started. In a previous video, we added a custom toolbar to the taskbar. Feel free to check out that video, Ace. I personally don't like the custom toolbar since you're left with a gap between the system tray and toolbar's icons. If we add more icons to the system tray, you'll see that the toolbar doesn't position itself with the system tray. I also don't like that the icons aren't on the same level as the system tray icons. So let's add a custom icon to the system tray, Ace. Fire up Google, type Tray Tools 2000 into the search field and it should be the first link. The link is in the description as well, Ace. Click Tray Tools Setup.exe to begin the download. Once it's done, launch the installer and follow the wizard. When it's installed, launch the Tray Tools program. As soon as it opens, the program will add several icons to the system tray. We can also remove the Tray Tools desktop shortcut by clicking the Explorer tab and checking the box beside Remove Icon from the desktop. Let's add our own icon to the system tray. Here I'm adding the folder that our icon will open. Click the Tools tab and click the Add button. Give your icon a name, then click the pen icon beside the program text field. Navigate to the explorer.exe and click Open. Open the folder you want to use, click the address bar and copy the folder's path. Paste the folder's path into the command text field, Ace. You can select if the program will open in a maximized, minimized or normal state by selecting the option you want from the drop-down menu. To choose a custom icon, click the pen icon beside the icon file text field. If you'd like to learn how to create your own custom icons, you can check out my video on how to do this. Here I'm using an icon I created earlier, which you can get from the channel files. The download link is in the description, Ace. Pick the checkbox beside Use a custom icon from the file below and click OK. Now your custom icon should appear in the system tray, and if we click it, it opens the custom tray icon folder. You can choose whether or not the icon will play a sound on launch, Ace. If you want to turn it off, click the Settings tab and uncheck the box beside Play Sound when launching Tray Tools. Your icon will now launch without the sound. To ensure the icon remains visible in the system tray, we need to set the icon to always show in the Windows settings. Click Exit on the Tray Tools program and head to the Notification and Actions section of the settings. Click Select when icons appear on the taskbar. From here you should see the custom icon we added with Windows Icon Tray Tools Launch Utility beside it. Below that, you'll see the name you gave the custom icon. In this case, it's Custom Tray Tool Icon. To make it so that the icon will remain visible, the switch button needs to be in the on state. Relaunch the Tray Tool program, Ace. You may also want to make sure that the Tray Tools 2000 icon is in the off state, so that it won't be visible in the system tray. You can also remove the ready-made Tray Tool icons, Ace. Open the Tray Tools program, select the icon you want to remove, and click Remove. Do this for all icons you want to remove, Ace. You may also want Tray Tools to run on Windows Startup. To do this, click the Explorer tab and click the checkbox beside Create a Startup Folder Item. Make sure that the folder you're using is in a safe location, Ace. Moving or deleting this folder won't cause an error when the icon is clicked, but instead of opening your folder, it'll open the Documents folder instead. Having custom system tray icons allows you to quickly navigate to your projects and folders, Ace, and should increase your productivity. And that's it. Rate, comment and subscribe, Ace. Feel free to give me feedback. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com with other productivity tools. Thank you for watching, Ace, and I'll see you in the next video.